Fala galera, você está assistindo Casa Nerd LOL.
E aí galera, hoje participamos da coletiva de imprensa da Netflix com o pessoal do 3%, o pessoal da 3 Reasons Why. Teve também Sense8 e Punho de Ferro. Então a gente vai passar para vocês agora o que aconteceu na coletiva de imprensa de Punho de Ferro. Então assista aí e aproveita o que, eles falaram.
A gente já desceu, passamos por um monte de gente lá em cima. Tá aqui a fila da imprensa para a coletiva da Netflix. A maninha tá lá guardando meu lugar. Olha aí, todo mundo. Vamos ver se eu vou conseguir gravar alguma coisa lá dentro. Mas eu estou muito empolgada para fazer as perguntinhas. Tá bom? Vamos lá. Vou voltar pra Amandinha.
Eu tenho alguns recados pra passar. Foto e filmagem, tranquilo. A gente vai fazer um esquema um pouquinho diferente de pergunta esse ano, porque a gente tá com quatro assuntos, né? Então é um pouco complicado da gente chamar cada um de vocês, até por causa da barreira da língua, enfim. Então a gente vai pegar as perguntas escrito com vocês.
Danny's journey is only just beginning, so it would feel really weird to kind of cut it off so short. So I definitely think we're going to see Danny around the corner, so I'm not sure, but nothing's going to be sure.
How about Ward? Are we going to see him?
Yeah, we better. I mean, damn, the dude stuck around to the end for a fucking reason, right? We better see him in the season two.
I have a question about the uniform. Are we going to see Iron Fist with the original uniform at some point?
Oh, the costume? Well, perhaps we might see some incarnation of a costume towards the end of Defenders, maybe. You know, Danny's on a journey to become a superhero. Throughout the first season of Iron Fist, he never... I don't even think he actually understands or knows what a superhero is, let alone who he is himself. So he's on this journey of discovery, and I think by the end of Defenders, he really understands what his purpose is. And I think moving forward, we're definitely going to see Danny Rand kind of take the Iron Fist responsibilities more seriously. And yeah, I think that would be cool.
Weird question. I don't think you know actually this. Are we going to see the Defenders in Infinity War?
No, I don't think so.
Yeah, right.
I don't think so. The problem is the filming schedules are so different for television and film, and so it'd be really difficult. I'd actually like to see the MCU thing come into the television world. I think that would be really interesting to see, like, Doctor Strange come into Iron Fist, or, like, you know, Captain America go into Jessica Jones. I think that'd be super interesting, kind of bring these movie superheroes and ground them in a television reality.
And
yeah, I agree. I think Ward should date Scarlett Johansson. Black Widow, right?
Yeah.
It only makes sense.
And Tom, you had a really rough first season. How was that for you to shoot that, to get in that mode?
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, as an actor, you love that opportunity, which was one of the things that made me so excited to get to play for. I will say, though, there was a certain point in there around episode 6, 7, 8, where we're dealing with a lot of the heavy use of drugs, the idea of withdrawals. And I wanted to you know, you would be pretty sweaty. So I wanted to be able to be sweaty without having to constantly spray me with water, which would actually cool me down. So I started wearing, when you film outside in the winter, they give you this layer of clothing for, it's like long johns and super thin, but it heats up your body. So I started wearing that underneath all my costumes when I was on set. So like, the sets are a little bit warm sometimes anyway. So I was just jacking myself up to gushing sweat. I mean, sometimes you could actually see on the show where the pig that I am, the sweat has actually come through like the back of my suit. That's real.
That's real sweat?
Yeah.
Oh my God, you really committed. How was it to do the character, Ward's character, that, in his opinion, has the best development arc of the entire series?
Yeah, I mean, it was great. You know, it's every actor, for me anyway, that's exactly what you're looking for when you take any job. You know, regardless of anything else, that you get a chance to really explore a character and that the writers are honoring that this is a, you know, a three-dimensional human being. You know, that I think Ward starts out in very difficult circumstances, and that he's using drugs and things to try and balance his behavior, and everything's kind of impossible, and then Danny comes back, and it really upsets the balance, and Ward kind of goes off the deep end, and Harold emerges, and all the secrets and all the skeletons are coming out of the closet, and we get to see this guy fall apart. But through it all, which is probably the most important thing, through it all, there's a through line, which is that Ward really loves his sister Joy more than anything. And I think you can watch the show and trace that through line through everything he does, through every episode, through every scene.
What were your biggest, what did you learn most while you two were filming Iron Fist? It's from Laís. Here we go.
What did we learn?
Yeah. While shooting it, did you learn anything?
I learned about endurance. Like, yeah. It was a real test of endurance. Just keep going through it and keeping the energy, keeping positive, keeping enthusiastic. Probably endurance.
I learned why people pay $3,000 for a suit. I was like, oh shit. Now I get it, and now I'm spoiled for life.
Told a funny story from set. Do you have a funny story from set?
I'm always terrible with all this stuff about funny stories. I don't really kind of keep them in my brain. No.
Okay.
I have, but they're just embarrassing and I'm not going to repeat them. Alright, I'm going to repeat it, why not?
There you go.
Okay. So at the end of episode 2, when Danny finally breaks free of the mental cell, and he runs towards the door and he does the Superman punch and punches through the door, as I was doing it, I was running down the corridor, I jumped up, I did the punch, as I landed the punch, I farted so big, like I just did the biggest fart ever. And it was really embarrassing, like, it was like my heroic escape.
That was a relaxing moment. Come on.
It's all those protein shakes.
Yeah.
You know, all that protein, it really fucks your gut. And I pretended like it didn't happen, but clearly, like, there was Brett the stunt guy. There was Greg the sound dude. You definitely heard it.
I wish I was there for that.
Did you not know that story? No. First time hearing it.
Yeah.
It's a good story. You can tell it as many times. Like, it's a good story.
Fantastic. Thank you for sharing.
And what can we expect from the future of Danny Rand?
I don't know.
Nothing?
Hopefully he'll just like get his shit together a little bit. You know, like he's a kid that's kind of wrought with trauma. He doesn't really understand his responsibility that well. I'd like to see him really kind of like, what we do see in Defenders, we start to see Danny not so much as a lost soul, and really trying to take his purpose and his mission a lot more seriously. And he grows up throughout the Defenders and finding his team as well, like it really establishes him, it kind of centers him a lot more. And I think moving forward, I'd like to kind of see Danny embrace the superhero within him and become do the right thing. It's interesting.
I have two interesting questions, actually. Kunlun wasn't really, we didn't really see Kunlun this season. Do you expect for us to see it at some point?
Yeah, I'd love to. I'd love to go to Kunlun.
Did you see any, like, arts for it? Like,
yeah, there was some art. Yeah, there was some art that I managed to get to see. Very green. I also did a lot of research, like, created in my own mind. So I pulled lots of images, a lot of ancient Tibet, ancient Tibetan villages I looked into, and I kind of had this big whiteboard in my kitchen at home, and I would just pin pictures of what I felt Kunlun was like. So whenever I was speaking about it, and whenever I referred to it, like, it was an actual place in me, you know, like, I
felt really,
yeah. So actually, that visualization, which is in me, is kind of more important to me than whatever the show does, because it's kind of what's in here that matters.
And season one had kind of like two villains. Do you guys want any villain for season two? Like, have you thought about that?
Yeah, maybe it would be Joy.
Joy seems like she's being set out to be bad.
Yeah, I mean, that ending was a bit ominous.
Yeah.
And Davos as well.
Yeah.
I think Davos is going to turn out to be the big bad. And I like the fact that they set it up as like he was my friend first, so you see where that goes, so it's not just so black and white. You know, you understand the history and the brotherhood that is between us, but then you also understand the tension and, you know, why they can't turn on each other.
So this is it, guys. I have to wrap it up, but they want to take some pictures if you guys could just stand here in the front.
Obrigado.